what would you like to say about the attitude of the current election commission, because there seems to be a loss of faith?
On a lighter vein, my comrades were just pulling my leg, saying that perhaps this is the period where I have written most intensively letters directed to the election commission. First, there were a set of issues relating from what should constitute the parameters of the model code of conduct. I think for your readers, you must know that model code of conduct was something which does not have statutory sanction, but all political parties, to be fair, had empowered the election commission to evolve a model code of conduct so that elections can be carried out in the country in a bipartisan manner without any bias. So at the very outset, it was reiterated that no use of religion, and secondly, no use of army and its institutions and the military feats of the government would be used. But they were more conspicuous in their violation. So we had to do it, and misuse of government machinery for the interest of the BJP, all those things, and where the Prime Minister was directly, but in the first phase they were sitting, and then later on they went issuing clean sheets. So that, I think, we played a major role in exposing that bias of the election. Second, actual holding of elections. You see this seven phases. We find that it was directly to help Prime Minister's campaign. And because he was not seeing green pastures in many parts of the country from the very beginning, West Bengal became a favorite haunt for him. I think for 42 seats, he has had 15 or 16 public meetings in Bengal alone. So if you have a comparative chart, you will understand how serious they took it. And obviously the poll schedule, starting with 11th of April and ending on 19th May, helped him. Then it has been our concrete experience that there was a tacit understanding between the TMC and BJP. This has been our experience, and therefore only those seats where BJP's interest in terms of victory was involved, the election commission was seen to be doing something. But where left was involved,
they have
facilitated things. So that is another thing. And in Tripura, we found that how brazenly the administration was used. And but we had piled up a tremendous amount of documentary evidence. As a result of this, they stopped the second phase. For two seats, we had two phases. And where they had to admit that a law and order situation under the BJP dispensation is so bad that they are further postponing it. So one seat, more or less some normal voting, but that first seat where it took them more than 1 month to decide on the repolling. We had documents that out of 1689 booths, 864 had been rigged. They had internal documents which admitted that 433 booths have been rigged.
So it was a good tally.
Yeah, absolutely. And then ultimately they gave repolling for 168, which is again very high considering the normal standards. It is about 10% of the booths. So therefore, this is how
How can this mishandling by the election commission be rectified? In terms of a statute, in terms of parliament?
You will see, first of all, we have to discuss after the elections what kind of electoral reforms. If you see the election manifesto of the CPIM, it has made a major component of our overall manifesto, where we talk about electoral reforms. One is this money power we have to reduce. Present situation, if there is space for the kind of corporate influence, there is no way that you can save Indian democracy. So no corporate funding for political parties. One. Secondly, you see, proportional representation you have to bring.
Yeah. Yeah.
You have to depersonalize the election and bring back policies and programs to the center stage, which is so apparent for the discussions of the Constituent Assembly. And thirdly, the use of caste and community, etc., in the electoral discourse. So there, I think some laws, some statutory provisions will have to be made. Here, Article 324 gives very sweeping, very
generally
exclusive and sweeping powers to the election. Now, specific laws have to be legislated
formulated
within the Article 325, under the 325, to really make it much more specific.
Which includes the appointment of the commission and all of that.
Everything. I mean, we have to strengthen the independence and the non-partisan role of the commission. That, with the sweeping powers that 324 provides, is not possible.
Thank you very, very much. Thank you.